The Catherine Palace is a Rococo palace in Tsarskoye Selo, 30 kilometers south of St. Petersburg, Russia. It was the summer residence of the Russian Tsars. History. Following the Great Northern War, Russia recovered the farm called Tsary Mas or Tsarskaya Myza, which resided on a hill 65 meters in elevation. In 1710, Peter the Great gave the estate to his wife Catherine I, the village of which was initially called Tsarskoye Selo, and then finally Tsarskoye Selo. In 1723, Catherine I's stone palace, designed by Johann Friedrich Bronstein and built by Johann Fürster, replaced the original wooden house. This was a two-story 16-room building, with state chambers finished in polished alabaster, while the upper one included Gobelin tapestry. The southeast portion of the estate included a garden designed by Jan Rusin, with terraces, stone staircases, parterres, trellised arbors, and ponds, while a menagerie was located on the opposite of the estate. During the reign of Peter the Great's daughter, Empress Elizabeth, Mikhail Zemtsov designed a new palace and work began in 1744. In 1745, Zemtsov's pupil, Andrei Kovasev, working with Sava Shevikinsky, expanded the palace to be 300 meters long. This included a middle house, two side wings, a chapel, and the conservatory hall, all connected by four galleries with hanging gardens. Then in 1751, Bartolomeo Rastrelli undertook a major reconstruction effort, integrating several buildings, giving the palace its distinctive snow-white columns, sky-blue walls, with gilded stucco, chapel cupolas, and sculptures requiring almost 100 kilograms of gold. Rastrelli's interiors were based on a Baroque style. Sculptor Johann Franz Dunker, master gilder Le Prince, and interior painter Giuseppe Valeriani were some of the distinguished artists. Other notable rooms included the Chinese room with its porcelain and caramandel lacquer panels, the portrait hall, the light gallery, and the amber room with Andreas Schluter's amber panels, while five anterooms were connected to the great hall, which measured 860 square meters. Construction ended in 1756, when the palace included 40 state apartments, and more than 100 private and service rooms. A new garden was added, while the old garden was improved with a deepening of the big pond, connected to springs 6 kilometers away, the addition of a toboggan slide, plus the hermitage, grotto, island, and Monbijou pavilions. Baroque architecture gave way to neoclassical architecture in the 1770s, when Tsarskoye Selo became the summer residence of Catherine the Great's court. Yuri Velton redesigned the south facade of the palace, while the side wings were converted from one story into four-story zubov and chapel annexes. The main staircase was replaced by state and private rooms such as the Chinese room, decorated with Charles Cameron designs, and a new staircase built in the center where the Chinese room had stood. Cameron's 1780s interior designs included the arabesque room with arabesque-painted ceiling, walls, and doors, while Greek and Roman classical motifs were used on the wall vertical panels. Cameron's lion's room used French golden-yellow silk on the walls, while the doors, stoves and panels used Lake Baikal lapis lazuli. The Empress bedroom used Wedgwood jasper bas-reliefs designed by John Flaxman and George Stubbs. The blue room, or snuffbox, incorporated white and bright blue glass on the walls. Giacomo Quarengi designed the mirror and silver rooms in 1789, while Rastrelli's hanging gardens were pulled down in 1773. Vasily Niyolov's 1768 master plan for Tsarskoye Selo was elaborated in 1771 by Johann Busch and implemented. Antonio Rinaldi added the Chesme Column, Morea Column, and the Kogel Obelisk to commemorate the victorious Russo-Turkish War. Niyolov's Gothic monuments included the Admiralty, the Hermitage Kitchen and Red Cascade, and his Chinese motifs included the Creaking Pagoda and the Great Caprice. Niyolov's early classicism monuments included the upper and lower baths. Niyolov built the opera house in 1778-79. In the 1780s, Cameron added the Thermae as part of Catherine the Great's Greek-Roman Rhapsody, and started building the Chinese village. Quarengi added a music pavilion and Ceres temple to an upper pond island. His kitchen ruin folly was added next to the concert hall. Niyolov's Babilovo Palace was added by 1785. And in the 1790s, Quarengi built the Alexander Palace. In 1809, Luigi Rusca built the Granite Terrace. In 1817, Stasov built the Triumphal Arch commemorating the Russian repulsion of the French invasion of Russia. From 1851 to 1852, Monageti added the Turkish bath. With Catherine the Great's death in 1796, park construction ceased. Vasily Stasov restored the damage caused by the 1820 fire, which included Rasrelli's chapel and adjoining apartments. In the 1850s, Andrei Stakenschneider decorated the stateroom ceilings with stucco ornament and Hermitage Museum canvases. In 1860, Ippolito Monageti reconstructed the central staircase and main porch. When the German forces retreated after the siege of Leningrad in World War II, they intentionally destroyed the residence, leaving only the hollow shell of the palace behind. Soviet archivists had managed to document a fair amount of the interior before the war, which proved of great importance in reconstructing the palace starting in 1957, by the State Control Commission for the Preservation of Monuments under the direction of Alexander Kudrinsky. Layout. Although Stasov's and Cameron's neoclassical interiors are superb manifestations of late 18th century and early 19th century taste, the palace is best known for Rasrelli's grand suite of formal rooms known as the Golden Enfilade. It starts at the spacious airy ballroom, the Grand Hall, or the Hall of Lights, with a spectacular painted ceiling, and comprises numerous distinctively decorated smaller rooms, including the recreated Amber Room. The Great Hall, or Light Gallery, as it was called in the 18th century, is a formal apartment in the Russian Baroque style designed by Bartolomeo Rastrelli between 1752 and 1756. The Great Hall was intended for more important receptions such as balls, formal dinners, and masquerades. The hall was painted in two colors and covers an area of approximately 1,000 square meters. Occupying the entire width of the palace, the windows on the eastern side look out onto the park while the windows of the western side look out to the palace plaza. In the evening, 696 lamps are lit on about a dozen chandeliers located near the mirrors. The hall's sculptural and gilded carvings and ornamentation were created according to sketches by Rastrelli and models by Johann Franz Duncker. Beyond the Great Hall is the courtiers in attendance dining room. The room was designed by Rastrelli in the mid-18th century. The small room is lit by four windows which look out into the formal courtyard. The architect placed false windows with mirrors and mirrored glass on the opposite wall, making the hall more spacious and bright. Decorated in the typical Baroque interior style, the hall is filled with gilded wall carvings, complex gilded pieces on the doors, and ornamental patterns of stylized flowers. The ceiling mural was painted by a well-known student of the Russian school from the mid-18th century. It is based on the Greek myth of the sun god Helios and the goddess of the dawn, Eos. Across from the courtiers in attendance dining room, on the other side of the main staircase, is the white formal dining room. The hall was used for the empress's formal dinners or evening meals. The walls of the dining hall were decorated with the utmost extravagance with gilded carvings. The furnishings consist of gilded carvings on the consoles. Some of the furniture which can be seen in the room today is original, whilst other pieces are reproductions. The painted mural, The Triumph of Apollo, is a copy of a painting completed in the 16th century by Italian artist Guido Reni. The portrait hall is a formal apartment covering 100 square meters. The room's walls boast large formal portraits of Empress Catherine I and Empress Elizabeth Petrovna, as well as paintings of Natalia Alexeyevna, sister of Peter the Great, and Empress Catherine II. The inlaid floors of the hall contain precious woods. The drawing room of Alexander I was designed between 1752 and 1756 and belonged to the emperor's private suite. The drawing room stood out from the rest of the formal rooms in the palace due to the fact that the walls were covered in Chinese silk. Other decor in the room was typical for the palace's formal rooms: a ceiling mural and gilded carvings. The elegant card tables and inlaid wood commode display Japanese, Chinese, and Berlin porcelain. The green dining room, which replaced Rastrelli's Hanging Garden in 1773, is the first of the rooms in the northern wing of the Catherine Palace, designed by Cameron for the future Emperor Paul and his wife. The room's pistachio-colored walls are lined with stucco figures by Ivan Mardos. During the Great Fire of 1820, the room was seriously damaged, thus sharing the fate of other Cameron interiors. It was subsequently restored under Stasov's direction. Other interiors by Cameron include the waiter's room, with an inlaid floor of rosewood, amaranth and mahogany and stylish Chippendale card tables. The blue formal dining room, with white and blue silk wallpaper and Carrara marble chimneys. The Chinese blue drawing room, a curious combination of Adam style with chinoiserie. the choir anteroom, with walls lined in apricot-colored silk, and the column boudoir of Alexander I, executed in the Pompeian style.
Thank you. We'll be right back.